Welcome back to my channel. This is Deeptima, and before I get started with the tutorial, a disclaimer. I'm not trying to look like Sonam Kapoor. This is just an inspired look. I really liked her two-tone eyeliner, and that's what I'm trying to recreate here. So before anything else, I started off with my eyebrows. I am reshaping my eyebrows because I'm going in for a curved eyebrow rather than an arched eyebrow. So just filling in some gaps and brushing my hair so that they all fall in the same direction. Using an eyeshadow, I am just going over the pencil product to set it, also to fill in any gaps and to make my eyebrows look a lot neater, fuller and defined. So you guys know the drill. And then I'm brushing wherever needed to blend the color. Furthermore, to clean my eyebrows, I'm using NYX eyeshadow base and I'm just applying it on the corners, like on the edges of my eyebrows, to make them look a lot neater and defined. This will not only clean my eyebrow area, like area around my eyebrow, this will also be really great to make the eyeshadows pop up and to make them last longer. Also, I'm applying the same eyeshadow base on my eyelids, and make sure you don't apply too much on your lids as well as on your lower lash line, because if you apply too much, it can get greasy and crease. Using Maybelline Color Tattoo in Bold Gold, I'm using it on my entire lid using a small brush. The color was like a little dry, so I'm like being really harsh on my lids right now. I'm pulling it really bad. I shouldn't be doing that, but I apologize. So I'm using MUA eyeshadow palette, and using this golden color, I would be setting the Bold Gold color tattoo by just applying that eyeshadow on top of it. And using Reveal 2 palette, I'm using a lighter gold. Now this gold will go in the inner corners, or the inner one third of my eyes. This will not only make my eyes look bigger, this will give a three-dimensional look to the eye. And make sure you blend everything nicely. Next, going in with the Maybelline palette again, I'm using these two shades to get the crease color. First, I'm going in with the lighter brown and just defining my crease, or you can say I'm just creating a crease, and I'm just blending it really nicely. This will be my transitioning color. Transitioning color, that means this will be the color that will help me blend the lid color and the highlight color. So I'm just applying that on the other eye using a fluffy brush. Next, going in with the taupey brown eyeshadow, I am concentrating this shade more on the outer corner, on the outer V and above the crease, to get that smoky effect going on. And take little product at a time and keep blending it. Take more and blend more, and that way you will get your desired smokiness or intensity. And make sure you keep comparing both your eyes, because you can't go wrong and you don't want your eyes to look different. They can never look exactly the same, but you want to try at least, right? So just keep blending the color. Moving on to the highlight, I'm still using the Maybelline palette, and the color, I'll just show that to you in a while. Like just one, two, and there you go. I'm using this color as a highlight. But sadly, the color was not showing up, so I shifted to my all-time favorite Buttermilk Nude by Coastal Scents, and I'm just applying that first under my brow bone, and then I'm blending it with a very soft hand. For my waterline, I'm using a pack eyeliner. I will write the name in the description box, so you do check that out. And after applying that, I am just blending it, or I'm just smoking it out on the lower lash line. And whatever is left on the brush, I'm just extending it to form a V, outer V, but like not a complete V. I'm just extending it out, as you can see. And make sure it doesn't look that harsh, so I'm just blending that. And applying the lighter brown in my outer corner to have intensity, to make my eyes look more cat-like and long. So you can see I'm taking my time, just doing what I love doing. I'm blending and reapplying my shades. So you have to do the exact exact. Okay, you have to do the exact same in order to achieve this look. If you feel the gold has faded off, you can reapply that. Using Faces Canada Solid Brown, I will apply it just on the inner corners of my eyes. I strongly feel that Sonam was not wearing a black eyeliner. It could be grey, but I think it was brown. And even if it was not brown, I'm really happy with my brown and gold liner. So I applied the liner. Next, I'm taking some liner on a brush, from a liner brush, and just going in between the lashes and trying to be like really close to the lash line in order to make my lashes look fuller and to make the gold eyeliner pop. So I'm using the MUA palette, the gold from the MUA palette, and I mixed it with some eye drops. I used Refresh Tears eye drops. So I just mixed both the products in a small container and applied my liner. Using the Lakme Quad, I am just going over the wet eyeliner to set it and also to make it pop and to make it more vibrant. So just take your time with your eyeliner, because if this liner goes wrong, trust me, you don't want to remove the entire makeup, because really it took me a long time to get the right amount of smokiness and to blend everything, and I really like it, to be very honest. So I'm just taking my time blending everything, and make sure you also blend the liner, like the brown and the gold. It should look seamless. And once I've applied the liner, I'm taking a tiny brush and using the darker taupey brown eyeshadow and just intensifying the outer corners. That will make the gold pop even more. Using Innisfree eyeshadow base, I am just applying it on the inner corners of my lower lash line so that the eyeshadow pops out more. I have used the word pop out a lot in this video. Okay, so the gold doesn't look that good, like doesn't show up that much on my skin. So I'm using like really good makeup, like eyeshadow bases. So I don't want to ruin the gold eyeliner effect. So I'm skipping eyelashes, just curling my lashes, and I applied loads of mascara because I felt if I apply eyelashes, the gold liner would not be visible, and I spent a lot of time doing it, so I want it to be visible. So no eyelashes, just some good mascara, like lots of it. There you go, looks really pretty. Moving on to the face, I use the Infallible 24-Hour Foundation, and this foundation is like a very warm tone foundation, and it oxidizes on me. It makes me look a little yellow, a little dark, but I love it because it gives me a lot of coverage. My English, oh my god. So it gives me a lot of coverage and I really like it. So as you can see, I will be just blending it on my entire face, leaving my under eye area. I will not be applying too much under my eyes because I would be using concealer, and the skin around your eye is very sensitive. So you don't want to layer it with products, otherwise it will cake, not cake, it will crease. So yeah. Make sure you take your foundation on your neck as well so that your face and your neck are the same color. Blend your foundation really nice. And next, moving on to highlight and conceal. So I'm using Maybelline and NARS. This is my favorite combination for under eyes. So I'm just highlighting on the usual areas. This is the NARS foundation, NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, not foundation. I can't talk, guys, today. Now again, it's time to blend. I'm blending my concealer and highlighter together. I mean, both are concealers, but I'm using one concealer's highlighter. So you can see how beautiful the under eye area looks, and my cheekbone looks a lot defined because I applied the lighter concealer on my cheekbone. So yeah, I really like how the combination of these two concealers look on me. Next, I'm just applying some loose powder. It is my regular Oriflame Studio Artist loose powder. Suggest me some good loose powder, guys. I really need to try something new. I'm using Mad About Mauve blush. I remember when this blush was launched, every blogger was raving about it, and it is actually a really nice blush. I really like this blush because it's really pigmented and it contours, it slims down my face actually. So I'm just applying that, like just pushing it with the brush on my skin, and then I will be blending it out. as you can see in the video. So just blend, and using my favorite sleek contour kit, I'm just slightly contouring my cheekbone. I would also be contouring my forehead and my jawline that you will see in a while. If you want to make your face look slimmer, try contouring your jawline. It really makes a lot of difference. I don't contour my jawline every single day because sometimes I like the full chubby look. I don't know, but yeah, I really like it sometimes. It looks really youthful and young and bubbly, whatnot. So yeah, just blending everything nicely and applying my highlighter. The highlighter is the same usual one, the sleek highlighter. Moving on to the lips, I'm using Catrice lip liner, and again the shade would be mentioned in the description box. You can check that out. Just applying my lip liner and filling my lips with the same. Now I am using this pale nude lipstick. I wasn't sure what Sonam had on her lips because in every photo, because of different lights, her lipstick was looking different in every picture. So I could have stopped here. You can see I could have stopped here, but nope, I did not. I layered it up with the Rimmel Apocalypse 101. I think that's a shade number, and this completes a look. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial and you find this video useful. If you like my interpretation of a look, please give this video a thumbs up and make sure you share it with your friends and leave your comments below. I would love to know your feedback. And I will talk to you guys soon in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.